our year of divine favor. Pastor, I prayed. Pastor, I waited upon God. I said, God, what do you have for us? What do you have for the church? I just don't want to sit down and give anything. He said, son, go and tell them that somebody you'll be favored. 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 In the name of Jesus. Let's read something quick. Please be seated. Be seated. Be seated. You see, Psalms chapter 102, verse 13. You arise and have compassion on Zion, for it is time to show favor to her. The appointed time has come. It is time to favor Zion. It is time to favor Elizabeth. It is time to favor Mary. It is time to favor John. It is time, your time to favor has come. Today, every word that cometh out of my mouth, jump and receive it. They are prophetic words. Amen. Favor means, Pastor, this is where God shows kindness to somebody. Favor, this is where God helps somebody. Favor, this is where God grants you something that is beyond your expectation, something beyond normal, something beyond usual. Favor is acceptance, favor is approval. Favor, may God show you favor. I said this year, we have two kinds of favor. I'm just laying foundation. Next week, God willing, we'll continue. We have two kinds of favor. Bible teaches us in Luke chapter 2, verse 52. He said, and Jesus grew in wisdom, in stature, and in favor with God and with men, women inclusive. The man grew in wisdom, in stature, and he had favor with God and with men. You see, when man favors you, it has an expiration date. It has a limitation. Men can favor you, and God can disfavor you. But anytime God favors you, men have no choice than to accept you. Anytime God favors you, I said, people have no choice than to accept you and to embrace you and to go with you. I said, this year may God favor somebody. May God remove men and may God himself come down. And I said, favor you in all your endeavor. If you are the one I'm speaking to, I thought you would jump and shout, I receive it, a big one. Let me give you four levels of favor. Then we pray. We have a basic favor. Other people call it elementary favor. It's a kind of favor that every Christian has. Every born again Christian, when you become born again, Paul said, we have been saved by grace. Amen. When you became born again through, I'm talking about through Christians. Amen. God gives you a basic favor. That favor encamps around you. That favor surrounds you like a shield. That is called elementary one. Pastor, then we have a distinguished favor. Somebody said distinguished favor. It's a favor that separates other people. You may have 30 people, 10 people, 100 people, they will go for an interview. And by the time you realize you are the only one that have been chosen, that favor has separated you from others. That favor has distinguished you from other people. May God give you a distinguishing favor so that it will separate you from your peers. When you step out and you are walking, people will identify you as a different person. When you get up and you are walking, people will see you as a special man. That's why Samuel said, "For God has favored me, and my mountain is standing strong." Your mountain is standing strong, which means it is different from others. Oh God. Oh God. I remember in the book of Ruth, chapter 2, verse 2 coming. Bible says that, and Ruth told Naomi, that Naomi, if I don't go out to work, we are going to die. So I want to go out, and wherever God gives me favor, in the sight of that person's farm, I will stay there and I will walk over there. You see, Ruth was a woman that everything was against. She was a woman who lost the husband. She was a woman who lost the father-in-law, lost the brother-in-law. She was a woman. I am talking about somebody who life has treated unfairly. The woman that life has treated unfairly. That woman, he came, I said, from Moab, the land of Moab. You get to understand that the Moab were the people that the descendant of Lot, the incestual children of Lot, they are the Moabites. And Bible teaches us that Moabites were technically like an outcast. The Israelites did not accept them as their own. They refused to embrace them. They refused to treat them fairly. It's like people migrating into other countries and into other regions and into other towns. And people would just look at you and they said, you have an accent. The way you talk, we can't understand you. You get an accent. So Ruth was a woman that people in the land were not what? Treating her fairly. She decided to go and work. As she went, oh God, she entered the farm of Boaz, the billionaire in town. Bible says that he was a wealthy man, a wealthy person, a well-to-do person, a respected person. I said, over there. And that time when she got there, Boaz was not at the farm. Boaz has gone out. And when Boaz came over there, Bible says that in verse 10, Ruth 2:10. Bible says that, and Boaz said, Ruth, you are special. Don't go anywhere. I want you to stay with the people. There were a lot of women who were growing, a lot of women who were working, a lot of women, pastor. But Ruth said, can you put it there for me? Ruth 2:10. I want to read it. I want us to see. Give me NIV. Ruth chapter 2, verse 10. At this, she bowed down with her face to the ground. She asked him, Boaz, why have I found such favor in your eyes that you notice me? Stay there. Why have I found favor in your sight, pastor, that you notice me, a foreigner, a person with an accent, a person without qualification, a person without an identity,
A person who was not recognized, as a matter of fact, when the favor of God comes upon your life, as a people will notice you wherever you are. It doesn't matter your background, it doesn't matter where you come from, it doesn't matter your qualification, as a people will notice you. People will notice you. People will notice you. You see, please hold their children. People will notice you. They will notice you. You see, you are a musician. You produce songs. But it looks like nobody has even seen your album. But this year, people will notice you. I say you are a woman. You are walking around. The men look as if they've not seen you. You are looking for a husband. You are looking for a wife. It looks like nobody has seen you. I am here to announce unto you, there is a favor that is coming upon your life that will call people to notice you. I said they will notice you, whether they like it or not. I said they will notice you. I am a katayabashabe. I am standing on the authority and the mandate of the Holy Spirit. I said they will notice you. I said they will find you. I said they will look for you. It doesn't matter whether you are beautiful or ugly. The favor. You see, sometimes you see a woman living in the house with a husband, and the husband will just go to computer and still be looking at other women. As if that woman is not in the house. Oh, I'm speaking to somebody who is watching me. I say, as if your husband is not noticing you. I say, you are there, but the man is on the phone talking to other women. I am speaking to somebody. I say, who is hearing me? I say, by the mandate of the Holy Spirit, I say, today I terminate anything that does not act. I say, call people to recognize you. I say, today I terminate anything that will not act. Allow people to see you. I say, today I remove, I say, any comment that I've been put on you. As a people will see you. Distinguishing favor. Pastor, sometimes it's not about beauty. It's about the favor of God. Sometimes you look at a man that is following a certain woman, and you look at that man, and you look at the top, and you look at the bottom, and you look at the top, and you look at down, and you look at the top. How did you manage to get this woman? Shout favor. Somebody 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 shout favor. Favor make difference. It makes difference. You look at the man and you look at the woman following him and you say, how come with all these beautiful women around, is this the only one? Favor. Shout favor. Favor. Somebody shout favor. Somebody shout favor. Favor will make you beautiful. Favor will make you handsome. Favor will make you special. Shout, I am special. Scream, I am special. Shout, I am different. Shout, I am special. Favor. You cannot tell me that Ruth was the only beautiful woman at that field. There were other women over there. But favor, when favor located her, the woman got married to the billionaire in town. I am here to announce unto somebody. I say, your husband will be different. I say, your wife will be different. I say, your husband will be different. I say, your wife will be different. If you are the one I'm speaking to, can you jump to your feet and give a shout of honor to God? Favor. It will separate you from others. Favor. Let me take you to another level because you are going to pray. I don't want to waste your time. Pastor, another level of favor. We call it the higher favor. Somebody said the higher favor. The higher favor was the kind of favor that produced Jesus Christ. When it came upon Mary, bam, the woman became pregnant. It's a favor that you cannot explain. At the same time, you cannot deny the evidence of it. It's a favor. When it comes upon your life, you cannot explain it. Neither can you also deny it, because it is there. Let me tell you something. People can criticize your words. People can criticize your actions, but they can never criticize the results. And they can never criticize the evidence. I said, when that favor comes upon your life, that favor produces results. Whether they like it or not, they will know that I am a Kato Sabaha, that you have become special. Pastor, last year, when I stood here and I declared that it's going to be our year of abundance, Holy Spirit spoke to me. He said, when I went to my, told my wife, I said, Mama, we have to take possession of this abundance. Let us go and register a business. I don't know the kind of business we are going to do, but we are going to register a business. Abundance LLC. And Pastor, to the glory of God, abundance has manifested. I said, anything you take possession of, I said, this year, if you can take possession, I said, of favor, favor will work in your life. Favor will be manifested in your life. I said, favor will grow in your life. You will become a different person. You will carry a higher favor, a higher dimension of favor, a higher dimension of favor, a higher dimension of favor. Somebody give a clap offering unto Jesus. Favor. Oh God. You see, Pastor, that favor, when God rests it upon your life, It's a divine endorsement. You see, when companies, they produce a product and they are marketing it, they want somebody to endorse it. The endorsement gives the product the credibility. The endorsement gives the product the marketability. The endorsement gives the product a value so that people will just go and buy it. Ladies and gentlemen, if you write a book right now and somebody who is credible, I say, and portable, I can tell you that your book will sell. I say, if you produce something and somebody who is credible endorses that thing, I say, that thing will grow. I am here to announce unto somebody that God is endorsing somebody. I say, Holy Spirit is endorsing somebody. He's putting a stamp on your ministry. He's putting a stamp on your marriage. He's putting a stamp on your business. He's endorsing you. He's endorsing you. He's endorsing you. Can I get believers in the house who are the Holy Spirit is endorsing tonight? Who the Holy Spirit is putting a stamp on it tonight? Endorsement. We call it divine endorsement. Joshua. When Moses died, in Joshua chapter 3, verse 7, God said, Joshua, today I have endorsed you because you have saved Moses, my servant. So today, Joshua, I am going to lift you up in the eyes of all the Israelites, and they will see that the God who was with Moses, the same God is also with you. He said, Joshua, this is what I'm going to do. For Moses lifted up the rod, and Moses parted the sea into two. But you, by this time, you are not going to lift up the rod. I am going to involve the people. They will be part of the miracle that is going to happen so that they cannot deny it. They cannot say that you call for another God that departed the Jordan River. So Joshua, go and tell the priest, let them carry the ark of God and let them step in that Jordan. And as soon as they step in that Jordan, the Jordan will be parted into two. You see, divine endorsement, it involves the people in your miracle. They cannot refuse it. They cannot deny it. They cannot reject it. Because that miracle, they are part of it. I am here to announce on to somebody that this year God is going to lift you up. I say, in the eyes of your relative, in the eyes of your friend, in the eyes in this ministry, I say, God is going to, I say, lift you up. He said, as Joshua, I will exalt you, 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 in the eyes of everyone. Everybody will see. Oh God. Oh God. There is a level in favor that when you get into, Pastor, people will see it. People will see. I was telling somebody, I said, you cannot hide the blessings of God. You cannot hide the favor of God. When it comes upon, it is impossible for you to hide it. It becomes very evident that people will see that this one God is. That's what God said. He said, Joshua, I am going to lift you up for everyone to see. This year, your favor, everyone will see. You alone, your wedding will be different. Hey! 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 I said, your wedding will be different. Your marriage will be different. Your business will be different. Your children will be different. I say your children will be different. And they will carry the favor of God. They will carry the favor of God. They will carry the favor of God. They will carry a higher favor. They will carry a higher favor. If you are the one I'm prophesying to, can I hear your voice in the house? Pastor, with the higher favor, when it comes upon your life, your children become different. People see your children and they ask, whose children are these? Have you heard people ask that thing before? Whose children are? Then you ask them why. They look different. So they look different. Child, they look different. Mama, this year my Benjamin is going to look different. He will carry a favor that has never happened before. A higher dimension of favor. You will see Benjamin and you say, whose son is this? And they will say that Pastor Edward Kwakye's last born. Favor, a higher favor. This year is my year. It's my year of favor. I said, whether you like it or not, Pastor, I will carry favor on my head. I will wear as a favor with me. And at my workplace, you will see me wearing favor. I will carry favor. My clothes will be favor. My shoe will be favor. Everything will be favor. I say everything will be favor. I say my microphone, I say, will be favor. Everything will be favor. A higher dimension of favor. A higher realm of favor. A higher favor. It becomes impossible. Let me tell you, with a higher favor, God will kill to defend you.
Amen.
When higher favor comes upon your life, I said, God will kill to defend you. When God favored Mary, when Herod was seeking to kill Jesus, the angel of God appeared unto Joseph. He said, leave this place, go to Egypt, for a time will come that I will call you from Egypt, because the person who is seeking, I said, to kill the son, I am about to kill that person because of a higher favor, a higher dimension of favor. And when they went to Egypt, they were immigrants, illegal immigrants. Jesus was illegal immigrant in Egypt. Mary was illegal immigrant in Egypt. Joseph was illegal immigrant in Egypt. They have no papers. They have no passport. They just entered the place. No visa. Who said you are illegal immigrant over here? I said, today I give you license to stay. Yeah. Hallelujah. Amen. Because Jesus himself was illegal. in Egypt because of favor. And one day the angel appeared unto Joseph. He said, Joseph, the one who is seeking the life of Jesus, that one is dead. Somebody shall dead. Somebody shall dead. Somebody shall dead. This year, anybody who will try to kill you, may that person die. Anything that will try to kill you, may that thing die. Anything that will try to kill you, I said, you are sitting down to receive. I said, prophetic declaration. Anything that will seek your life, I said, may that thing die. 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 Can I hear a big amen? A higher favor. If you tamper with the person, you will die. That's why you have to be very careful. I am speaking to somebody. You don't know the kind of favor that somebody carries. Be very careful when you talk about people so that you don't die. Be very careful when you are seeking a damn for others so that you don't die, because you don't know the kind of favor that somebody has carries in life. A higher dimension of favor. And with a higher dimension of favor, Pastor, it comes with a special assignment. Special assignment. When that favor comes upon your life, you are not an ordinary. You have a special assignment to do. Maybe in your family, God will just lift you up and say, you be the provider for the family. That's a special assignment. He said, Jeremiah, before your mother and your father came together, I knew you. For I have appointed you. It comes with what? Assignment. Special assignment. Higher favor. Let me give you the last one. I call it exceptional favor. Somebody shout exceptional. Shout exceptional. Shout exceptional. That one, Pastor, it gives you an unlimited resources and unlimited access to heaven. Oh, I was praying. I was asking God. I said, God, I love higher favor, but I also want an exceptional favor. An uncommon favor. That was the favor that came upon Solomon. When Solomon went to Gibeon, in 1 Kings chapter 3, verse 5 to 13, Bible says that after the sacrifice, God appeared unto Solomon. And he said, Solomon, ask me whatever you want. Whatever. God, come and ask me. Ask me whatever you want. At Gibeon, the Lord appeared to Solomon during the night in a dream, and God said, ask for whatever you want me to give you. This one, we call it a blank check. Blank check. God has signed a check. He has put your name on it. He said, just write the amount. A blank check. That write whatever amount that you want on it, and I will give it to you. Ask me whatever you want. We call it exceptional favor, uncommon favor. Hey God, please ask me that question this year. God, please, this one. I want a Cessna. Ask me that question. Ask me this year. I need that question. Blank check, give me blank. And Solomon said, God, just give me wisdom, a discerning spirit. And God said, Solomon, because you've asked for this, I will give you word and honor. May God give you exceptional favor. I said, may God give you an exceptional favor this year. Pastor, Esther went to the king. And while she entered the palace, the king looked at her and said, Queen Esther, what do you want me to do for you? Even up to the half of the kingdom, I will give it to you. Half of the kingdom, the biggest kingdom at that time. Hey, this year, may your husband ask you, hey, honey, ask me whatever you want. Amen. Brother Francis, your wife will ask you. Ask me whatever you want, and I will give it to you. He said, even up to the half of my kingdom. I said, today, that favor is exceptional. Pastor, that favor is exceptional. I stand on this altar and I prophesy over somebody's life that this year may you receive an exceptional favor. I said, this year may you possess an exceptional favor. I said, this year may you walk in an exceptional favor. I said, this year may you be clothed with exceptional favor, an uncommon favor, unprecedented favor, favor that has never happened before, an exceptional favor unto the heart of the kingdom. I said, give me. He said, ask me what you want up to the half of my kingdom, and I will give it to you. Up to the half. This is an uncommon favor. Let me tell you something. Pastor, the whole night I waited upon God. I wake up around 12. I waited upon God, prayed throughout the whole night. And when I was praying, God showed me something. We will enter into the realm of prophecy. God said, my son, look, I saw it was written here, goodness. I said, God, what is this? He said, this year I am going to show somebody an uncommon goodness. I said, in the church, somebody who is watching, he said, I am going to show somebody an uncommon goodness, a goodness that is not common to mankind. A good, that was when I understood that this year somebody will be blessed, whether the enemy like it or not. I said, you'll be blessed, whether the enemy like it or not. I said, you'll be blessed, you'll be favored, you'll be favored, you'll be favored, you'll be favored, you'll be favored. An exceptional favor. Goodness. That's why he said, it is now time for me to favor Zion. It is now time for God to favor you. In this land, in this ministry, wherever you go, God will favor you. He said, Solomon, ask me whatever you want, up to the half of my kingdom. Esther, Solomon, a blank check. You see, sometimes people write a check and they don't sign. You cannot cash it. Is it not true? Sometimes some of the check will jump. They call it, it has bounced. I call it a jumping check. Because the check jumped from the account. When you put it there, it left the account. A jumping check. God is saying that this year is your year. I said, this year is your year. I said, this year is your year. I want you to speak to yourself that this year is my year. It's my year of exceptional favor. It's my year of exceptional favor. It is my year of... Prophesy to your soul, prophesy to your spirit, prophesy to yourself that this year is my year of exceptional favor, a higher favor, an exceptional favor. Pay your soul, pay your spirit, 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 that this year. I don't know what you want this year. I don't know what you need this year. But that favor can bring it. Somebody once said, 100 years of labor, a day of favor is bigger than 100 years of favor. Labor is good because labor will give you reward. But favor will give you access. Labor will give you reward. But favor will give you access. I need access to the palace. I need access to the king. I need access. I need access. This year, there is going to be a special favor.